of the wrist. One bounce, two, and over the rope. Well, if he plays for any period of time here, Harry Brook, one thing you'll pick up is that he very rarely plays from the same position at the crease. He's often just going across, he stays leg side, he comes down, he goes back. And so he just creates a little problem for the bowlers.
And that means you can access the offside. First runs, first boundary for Brook in Test match cricket.
He will remember this forever. Good balance, waited for it. Perfect.
Fine shot. Lovely cricketing shot, this.
That movement back, he gives himself room to create the opportunity for him to go over extra cover, but that is a great position to play the shot.
And again, cheeky but effective.
Well, this young man is very talented. Harry Brook, who was feigning to go then to look to hit leg side and had to change at the last minute.
Square up, goes behind square for four, back-to-back boundaries. He moves to eight, England 96 for three.
It was wide, it was full, and he got enough of it, to be fair to him.
Well, he certainly fits in to the mindset of this England lineup, that is for certain.
That's well struck. One bounce over the rope at square leg. Picked his spot nicely.
Picks up a short ball from Avesh Khan and thumps it away over square leg.
Yes, that's a fine shot for someone who's just come in there. Very quick to spot the length. That's well struck. Down the ground, we'll find the boundary.
But in the last, I'd say, 18 months or so, he tends to just put them in the right order, and he picked the googly.
Hit hard by Harry Brook. Hit really hard through the offside. His second four.
Just a little bit short. The trajectory is flat from Akshar. He's welcome to the crease with a boundary.
Guided and guided fine by Harry Brook for his first boundary.
That's what he's bowling. Harry Brook, he just knocks it on its head. How many times did we see Joe Root and Johnny Bairstow just do this just off late in the last couple of weeks? So much control.